I think it's pretty safe to say that taurine, an active ingredient found in many energy drinks like Red Bull and Monster, has a pretty bad reputation. Probably has something to do with the fact that energy drinks themselves have a pretty bad reputation. After all, energy drinks have been responsible for several deaths over the last few years, including that of a 16-year-old girl from Arizona who died shortly after consuming several cans of Red Bull while on vacation with her family. Another girl, 14, suffered a cardiac arrest after having had just 2 servings of the 24-ounce energy drink Monster. And they're not alone, because according to one conservative estimate, there were at least 34 energy drink-related deaths in the United States in the 10 years between 2004 and 2014. Which may explain why Red Bull was banned by the French government for 12 years between 1996 and 2008. In those 12 years, you could only buy a toned-down version of Red Bull in France. Let's call it Kiddie Red Bull. That version contained no taurine. The French government, it seemed, did not have a problem with energy drinks per se, but they almost definitely had a problem with one of their key ingredients, taurine. But is taurine really as dangerous as people make it out to be? And why do the companies that make the energy drinks add it into the mix anyway? Let's find out. My name is Hesham and I'm a University of Cambridge graduate and student doctor, and this is Doctor Tell Me Why, a medical YouTube channel where I get to read all about medicine and science and share the cool stuff that I learn with you guys. If you'd like to join me on this journey, then you probably know what you need to do. Taurine is a naturally occurring amino acid found in abundance in fish and meat products. A typical omnivore diet will contain anywhere between 40 to 400 milligrams of taurine each day, depending on how much meat and fish you consume and how the meat and fish are prepared. Cooking tends to destroy taurine, and so the diets that contain the most taurine tend to be raw diets. Energy drinks, however, promise more taurine than you can ever get through diet alone. Both Red Bull and Monster will typically offer 1000 milligrams of taurine per 8-ounce serving, which is nothing unusual, to be honest, because it's basically industry practice to add anywhere between 750 and 1000 milligrams of taurine per 8-ounce serving. But why add so much? Humans actually have a hell of a lot of taurine, even if you've never had an energy drink in your life. Taurine is present in the fetal brain in higher concentrations than any other amino acid. And taurine is still the second most prevalent amino acid in the adult brain, being found in particularly high quantities in the hippocampus, cerebellum, and hypothalamus. From what we know so far, taurine appears to be absolutely essential for normal brain development, and it appears to protect the brain from oxidative stress and oxidative damage in later years. Energy drink companies, however, appear to be interested in taurine for a completely different reason. Your skeletal muscles are filthy rich in taurine, and individuals who are better trained or more athletic tend to have higher concentrations of taurine in their muscles than those who are not. The plot thickens when you realize that taurine, unlike other amino acids, is not actually used to build proteins, and hence, muscles. Despite this, however, an important study was able to show that mice that were genetically engineered to be deficient in taurine had reduced exercise capacity. And we're not just talking small numbers here. Taurine deficiency reduced exercise capacity by a whopping 80% compared to the control mice. Taurine may not be one of the building blocks needed to build muscle, but you sure as hell are not gonna run very far without it. And so, we arrive at this idea that taurine may be a promising ergogenic. An ergogenic being any substance that enhances physical performance and ability, eliminating fatigue and prolonging endurance. Before I tell you guys about how and why taurine improves athletic performance, I have a tiny announcement to make. I've started a free newsletter on Substack. You'll get one email from me once every fortnight, and in that email I include the coolest medical and science stuff that I've come across on the internet. Things that I think you guys should know about. I'll also include all the references that I use in the making of my videos over there too. So if you're interested in that, you should find a link in the description below. And now back to taurine. Taurine is believed to enhance athletic performance through two main ways. Through altering cellular metabolism and through reducing inflammation and oxidative stress following exercise. First, cellular metabolism. There is a substantial amount of research that taurine improves insulin sensitivity and glucose utilization into energy by muscle cells during exercise. Taurine also enhances the breakdown of fats into fatty acids that may also be used as fuel during exercise. And indeed, in one study, a group of cyclists were able to burn 16% more fat by consuming 1.66 grams of taurine daily. It appears that taurine targets the cell's mitochondria, also known as the cellular powerhouse responsible for generating energy. It's here that, in a similar way to cardarin, which we discussed a few weeks back, taurine upregulates the PPAR genes, which play a vital role in regulating energy supply and demand within the cell, and hence potentially improving exercise capacity. And at least one study seems to agree, noting a marked improvement in VO2 max, exercise time, and total workload following 7 days on a relatively high dose of taurine. 6 grams or the equivalent of 6 cans of Red Bull. Rest assured, however, the participants in that study were not asked to consume 6 cans of Red Bull each day. Now, onto oxidative stress. It's no secret that exercise is responsible for a lot of oxidative stress and inflammation, in the short term at least. It's the reason why you feel sore the morning after a particularly tough workout. When your muscles are pushed, they end up releasing a bunch of inflammatory markers and reactive oxygen species. And taurine can clean those up, because it's actually a somewhat powerful antioxidant. This was put to the test in one 2017 study where two groups of participants were asked to perform 60 consecutive bicep contractions at maximum force. While neither group regained full muscle power in the 72 hours following the experiment, those dosed with taurine demonstrated greater power, were less sore, and had a better overall recovery compared to those receiving placebo. The dose used in that experiment was 0.1 mg per kilogram per day or 6 grams for a 60 kg individual, similar to that used in the previous experiment. The findings are, however, mixed. While some experiments like the ones I mentioned show taurine to be very effective and very promising as an ergogenic, other experiments show no significant differences whatsoever following taurine administration. It's a mixed bag to say the least, and I encourage everyone to do their own research. Regardless, however, one thing is clear, clear as daylight, taurine is safe, very safe, much safer than caffeine, in fact. It's not toxic, it's not carcinogenic, it's not teratogenic. And while the scientific consensus is that you should not have more than 3 grams of taurine each day, experiments have been performed on humans where the participants were given 10 grams of taurine for periods as long as 6 months. The participants were completely fine and no adverse effects were observed. Compare that to caffeine, which begins to show manifestations at just 1 gram and will almost definitely kill most people watching this video at 10 grams, consumed within a 24-hour period. In short, energy drinks really do kill people, but the French government was both wrong and stupid to point its finger out at taurine. Especially as throughout the 12 years it was banned, Kitty Red Bull continued to be sold in France, with just as much caffeine as regular Red Bull, but without the taurine. Despite there being no scientific evidence, not back then, not now, that taurine was harmful in any quantity. I think a lot of you guys will agree with me in saying that if the last year has taught us anything, it should be that science-backed policy is what we need most as a society and not witch hunts. Which is why you should definitely subscribe to this channel. I rest my case. Who said doctors don't make the best lawyers?